What's up, TV Trucking in Atlanta? On my way going to the Martin Yard, really, it's Atlanta, Tucker, Georgia, St. Crabs, right outside of Atlanta. On my way to the yard, 8 miles away, I figured I'd take y'all on a ride to our yard and see what it looks like. It's one of the better yards that Martin has. I think the best yard. That was in Texas. They said that I haven't been there to Texas. The only one I knew was this one. And the one in Pennsylvania. The one in Indianapolis is a nice one. It's a nice yard. This is the biggest yard out of all of them. Now, the one they have in Memphis is big, but it's big and empty. It's a big, empty ass yard. One in Virginia I've been to only once. I think I've only been to the one in Virginia once. I was getting a load to get home. I got a whole week before I'm home. I'll go home until next Friday, so I got a little ways to go home after. I got a whole week of running recaps. Probably be all on recaps. So I'm probably going to get to 34 grand. You know how companies are when it comes to 34%. They can care less unless you're leasing. You force yourself to do a 34, then it just costs you money. So anybody been through that, you know what I'm talking about. Yes, so on my way to Tucker, Georgia to go to a yard. The place I'm delivering at doesn't have overnight parking, so I know I have to deliver anywhere around Atlanta. If I have the hours, I always make sure I make it to the yard. And it makes it easier for me to get up. I can get fuel at the yard. I can get my def at the yard. So it makes it easy. I go through the truck wash, which I need. Get all this white stuff off this truck. All that sand, rain, whatever. Up in the Midwest. Parking lots on the parking. Snow, rain, everything else is going on up there. Other than that, I've been down to Georgia, Florida, mostly ever since I came from Indiana. I was straight to Florida. I've been around in Florida for the past 2 days. Now, this past day, I'm coming up to Georgia. They, you know,
2 miles. Pickens in 3, 9B on the right, 4, US 7, in East, Evans, and Snellville.
I'm on the way up to Atlanta, which they always do. They say this is where all the freight is. We'll see tomorrow after I drop where my next load is going to be. I'm not sure. This may be a drop tomorrow, but even for a drop and hook up here, you still can't do it whenever you want to. It still has to be the day that's going to be, which is the next day, or it has to be on the time, by that time that you have the schedule. It's not like Walmart dropping hooks where you can just drop anytime. As soon as you get there, just go ahead and drop it on that date. It still has to be around that time that your schedule will drop, that you drop up here. So, it's an odd place. Drop, obviously, we must got trailers there.
In 1 mile, take exit 3D, 9B on the right, 4, US 7, in East, Evans, and Snellville.
I have a Red Bull blue on here, so I'm loaded with Red Bull. Anybody ever been to the place in over by Savannah where the Red Bull place is? They, you know, you gotta put fingerprints on the paper, copy your license. I guess the Red Bull must be a valuable loot. Very valuable. You gotta do all of that to be able to take the loot. Usually I get loaded there, but for some reason this time it was preloaded. The trailer was preloaded. So, we'll see. game, watch Dallas lose, hopefully. I don't know why I hate that team, man. I used to like that team when I was a kid. I can't stand Dallas now. I don't know if it's just the fans, they get on my nerves, or what. I don't know what it is about Dallas. And every time they lose, I'm just happy, man. Maybe it's the owner. They had a bunch of good players back in the day, man. Good coach, everything. I was shocked. When they fired Jimmy Johnson, I was like, what in the world? Like, they could have had the dynasty of all dynasties. But the owner wanted credit. And Jimmy Johnson was not giving him his due. He wanted credit for buying the team. Ain't none of that got nothing to do with the product you're putting out on the field. Nothing. It's all about coaching. And he has never understood that. Never understood that. And that's why Dallas has been the laughing stock in the NFL past. Every year you ask Dallas fans, they act like they're going to win the Super Bowl every day. My team didn't even exist last time they won a Super Bowl. The Ravens wasn't even a team. And Baltimore was still trying to get a team back in Baltimore then. Last time they won the Super Bowl. Oh, mercy. I don't understand. We done won two Super Bowls. And I span my 10 years in between the Super Bowls. And they ain't won nothing. Absolutely. They might win a third before they win another. They're just ridiculous. Merge to the damn highway. Are you driving with the traffic? You got to get in. We're in Atlanta, man. There's some good driving people with you. You're a truck driver, so you got to drive for the traffic around you. You can't just drive to get to where you're going. You got to drive for these dummies. Because it's always your fault. Even if they do something stupid. It's always your fault. So you have to drive for the traffic around you. Even if they're doing stupid stuff in front of you, you still have to drive according to how they're driving. So it is what it is. I got like a mile and a half going there. We'll be almost there. And they had this thing with our pool comms. I don't know if everybody else. Systems were down everywhere, and they were wanting us to use our cell phones to move around. And I was like, "No, man, I'm not using my cell phone to move around. Like, y'all owe me breakdown pay or something. Man, I'm not using my cell. I used my cell phone one time, and I almost. Luckily, my instincts. I've been driving long enough, and my instincts know when I'm in a bad situation." I'm able to read where
on the right for Mountain Boulevard.
Little trucks are loud, groups and low bridges. It's mostly about the low bridges. Especially when you're in the Northeast.
Turn left to Mountain Industrial Boulevard.
You know, the Northeast has all kinds of crazy low bridges, so that's why you cannot use your cell phone.
Turn left to Mountain Industrial Boulevard.
Companies don't care. They'll try to get you to use a cell phone any day. They don't care, man. They could care less. And then catch an attitude when you tell them no. Yeah, he called a straight attitude with me. Like, what? So you're saying no? Like, yeah, I'm saying no. Like, no, I'm not doing it. Oh, so you're just going to sit till tomorrow? Yeah, I'm going to sit till tomorrow until y'all fix the Qualcomm GPS. Like, I don't know what part of that don't you understand. Like, I'm not moving. So you must just go ahead and just go home then. That's what I did. I went on home. I wasn't that far from home. I went a couple of hours anyway, so I called an extra day home. I didn't turn down the load. I didn't turn down work. You know, something ain't working. I'm not gonna go. Luckily I know my way home. I don't really
proceed
need
north
my,
on Mountain Industrial Boulevard in a half mile.
GPS.
Turn right to Roger Martin Way.
So I wasn't really worried about going home. It was when you're doing the Michaels. They got Michaels. They do. We got got a Michaels contract up in PA, and it goes to PA. So you might go PA to Virginia, to Maryland, or PA, you know what I mean, where you got to spend the night in the back of the Michaels parking lot and all that stuff. Like, I don't know how people do that dedicated, but I really don't know. Like, you never get a chance to stop to a truck stop or nothing. Because they run your time to where you have nothing else to do but make go all the way back up PA to get another trailer, go all the way up from PA to Jersey. You know what I'm saying? Stay overnight in the back of the Michaels parking lot. Get up 3-4 o'clock in the morning, make the delivery. Like, it's crazy. Like, it's really, really crazy, man. And the reason I stopped here, because you don't want to block an intersection when you're in the tractor trailer. So I could have been up there where the car was, but the whole back of my trailer would have been blocking some water. I do a good job. Sometimes you're going to make a mistake.
Turn right to Roger Martin Way.
You're going to think traffic is moving and traffic is not moving. And I hate that. It happens sometimes.
Proceed east on Roger Martin Way in a quarter mile. Look for your destination on the left.
I don't be having my ID. I'm having to get somebody over the gate. Hopefully I got it this time. Maybe my jacket or something. Because I don't have it hooked on my...
Look for your destination on the lap.
On the clip, like I used to. I used to have it hooked on a clip.
Destination.
There it is. There it is. I need that to get inside this gate. Get inside the gate. Just slide it through. Just slide it down. Get in. If you're still employed, then it lets you in. So you'll know if you have, no longer have a job here, that the gate won't go up. All these brand new Kentworths out here. Make this turn. You see these Kentworths. All these brand new trucks. They got more off to the left. You can't see those. Turn right back here. Look at all the brand new Kentworths. All of them. They got all us riding around in old, ugly, behind freight liners. They got all the brand new trucks. Fairly busy yard out here. Everybody at right there, number one employee out here. Man, that's the only thing that drives me crazy. Well, I come over here and I hate it. Sometimes. What's going on? See somebody. See somebody. bitch ain't working. Later on about this game going on tonight, these Cowboys, and not anybody really wants to hear about that, but that's what I do. All right, TBE Trucking, I'm out, man.